Hi, I'm Toni Williams, and this is Brooklyn Savvy. Anyone who's lived in Brooklyn over the past decade can't help but marvel at how much the borough has changed. Today, we'll explore why Brooklyn is so hot. Hot. Anyway, with our guest, Abby Hamlin. And you're a developer, Abby, and thank you so much for joining us.
I'm delighted to be here.
But before we start to question you on Brooklyn and its brand and all of that, I want to introduce our Savvy panel. We have Tracy Smith,
Hello.
Denise Arbisu, and Ellen Saul-Peter. So can you tell us, Abby, what is driving this whole Brooklyn brand? What's underneath it?
Okay. I think brand is a multifaceted concept. Mm-hmm. So we have the part of brand that's marketing mm-hmm. and what is being imposed upon the notion of Brooklyn. And then we have the intrinsic.
I like that word
authentic.
Being
pulled. Yeah. It's the authentic, the authentic Brooklyn.
Mm-hmm. Right.
And if you ask me personally, the authentic Brooklyn brand is the harder, the creative culture that mm-hmm. Brooklyn is all about.
Mm-hmm.
And that's what's driving. It's the really underlying all of the layering of the marketing on top of that. It's the creative culture. It's the arts. It's the food. It's music. It's mm-hmm. everything that is going into what's drawing people to think about Brooklyn in a different way from the way they thought about Brooklyn mm-hmm. in the past. Now, above and beyond that, we have a little bit slicker notion of branding, and that this is a hipster place to be, and this
right.
is a young place to be, and a place you want to be. But I think that with absent that creative culture underlying the brand, it wouldn't be so hot.
And haven't developers historically followed artists? When you talk about the creativity, and usually develop where the artists go, you typically find.
It's so funny you're saying that,
yeah.
Tracy, because I was just saying, I lived in what's now known as Dumbo, but mm-hmm. didn't have an acronym when I moved in
right.
as an artist and an arts worker in an artist community.
How long ago was that?
1986.
Okay, it was not Dumbo.
There were actually buildings
the
down there, right?
The same buildings. Yeah, I mean, there's
right.
new construction
right.
as well, but we were a community of artists. We were brought in by factory owners. The Borum & Pease factory was
mm-hmm.
still active.
Right.
The empty lot that's still owned by the Jehovah's Witness was a building and
right.
a school
mm-hmm.
that was torn down for development, which they still have not developed. And we were brought in to make the neighborhood safe. And then it was kind of, you called someone in your building when you got out of the train and said, I'm walking two blocks. If I don't show up within 10 minutes, come find me.
Mm-hmm. Okay.